What this is Minecraft Education Edition has an hour of code, and we want to make sure you guys get some more STEM skills while you're here. So they have a few activities we can do, actually, besides just coding. So if you guys are ever interested in any of those, please let me know. But for today, we are going to do this hour of code activity they have here, and we're going to do it together. So I'll read aloud. It says, this is a one-hour introduction to computer science design to demonstrate AI. Introduce coding into Minecraft and broaden participation in the field of computer science. So we will be doing this hour of code, AI for Good. It is a beginner class, and we're going to get started. Okay, guys? All right, it is loading. So I'm going to go through it, and I want you guys to help me get through this whole course in the chat. Okay, so once it loads up, we will get started. Okay, so we must talk to the researcher. I assume we just walk forward and right click on them. Welcome to the Research Center. Here you will learn how to use AI and coding to prevent fires. Your first task is to use coding to open this gate. Press C to start coding. Okay, it is loading up the code builder now. Yes, awesome. Okay, so for the first one, we have to open up the gate. And to do that, we're going to use this block code, and you just drag it inside this on start. So once we start running the program, what this is going to do, oh, no, it switched sides on me. So what this is going to do is it's going to, as you would expect, open the gate. So we click play. And now the gate opens. Awesome. Let me fix the chat box. I don't know why it moved again. Okay. So we did it, guys. Here is the engineer. This is the agent. You can program the agent like you did with the gate. Code the agent to move 3 steps forward to stop on the marker. Press C to start coding. So if we want them to move, all we have to do now is wait for the tutorial to open up, and we must move the bot, so move the agent. So can you guys tell me in chat how we can do this? All we have is this agent move forward snip of code. We can tell how far we want them to move, and then we have to make a move to the spot. Can anybody type in chat of what we have to do? All right, so Alan said drag in the block and set it to 3 times. Does everybody else agree? I got a few nods. All right, so 4, 3. We're going to hit play and see what happens. Well, there it is. We finished it. So now we must talk to the researcher. Researcher is right here. The agent needs to collect data about flammable materials that could pose a fire hazard. Code the agent to, how do you get to the server? There is no server. When we do play Minecraft, it's on a single player. And so once we get there, I'll explain that a little bit more. Code the agent to move 4 spaces forward toward the dry brush and then analyze forward to collect the data. All right, so we must code once again. Okay, so agent analyze. So here is the next snippet of code we have to write, guys. Move your agent to analyze the dry brush. Use agent analyze forward last. Think about the number of steps you need to move the agent forward. When finished writing your code, click the play button to run your code in-game. So how far do you guys think we have to move? I think that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Same thing, but 4 times, okay. We change this to 4. and drag analyze after that. Okay, so play. Wow, nice first try. So we must get to the top of the tower. Look over the edge of the building and you'll see that the agent training maze. Don't worry, you can't fall off. Choose a path button below. Use code to move the agent through the maze to research the dry brush and analyze it. Do we want the long or short path, everybody? Long path, okay. So everybody's saying long path, and luckily we chose it. So this is the long path. You guys tell me how to get there. Let's see what blocks we have. Okay, so we have to gather data again. Let's see if we can view. So that's two blocks forward, and then we go to the left. No, our bots, that's the short path over there. We picked the long path. So I'm gonna try and set it up in a way where you guys can see the whole path while we code. All right. If you guys could type in chat, what's the first thing we need to do? Forward at two, turn left. Okay, so move this forward. You said two, and then we turn left. So if I run this now, we'll be here. After that, what do you think we need to do? Let's see if we run it and see what happens. Okay, so this is currently where we're at. We make it to right there. Anybody else? Forward by four, okay. So now we move forward by four. So let's see where that takes us. Okay, so we made it here. We're slowly making progress, guys. What next? Turn right. Okay, so now we're turning right, and we'll see where that takes us this time. Okay, so we're facing the correct direction. I'm going to do this little part here, so I say we move forward two. Oops. There we go. Move forward two. And let's see where that gets us now. Okay, so we're here. We turn right. Okay. Now what, guys? We make it to right here. Forward four. Okay. Forward by four. And that puts us here. There is another left two, so turn left, move forward by two. Okay, he said turn left again. Turn left. Okay, so we're almost there. We have just a little bit of ways to go. So another move forward by two. Okay, awesome. And that puts us right here. So now we have just these few blocks to go. turn. Forward two again. Okay, forward two. Where does that take us now? We go to the right. Okay. Turn left. So you said turn left, forward to analyze. Okay. Forward, and now we finish it off with the analyze. Okay, let's see how far we made it. Oh, we got to go forward two. I forgot to change that. My apologies. Like you said, two. Okay. Awesome. So go down the ladder and find the head of research.
Be sure to join TechDev Academy's workshops and camps, and also read some great articles on their blog page.